sports analytics is just data analytics that is applied in sports. Thank you guys and welcome back once again to this weekly podcast to Data Insights. Today I'm privileged to be joined with a data scientist and a sports analytics expert. With me here is Tony Nyamau. Tony, good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome.
Thank you. My pleasure.
Yes, thank you, Tony. So, Tony, with the emergence of various technologies, we have seen a rise in a lot of data being produced, and this has led to several career paths, like we have data science, we have data analytics, and we are having several other career paths in the field of data. And yours is a bit different. You are a sports analytics expert. So what is the difference between sports analytics, data science? So are these fields one and the same?
Okay, thank you. Data science is wide. As we all know, data science is wide. And the part whereby data analytics comes into place helps data scientists to be able to know which kind of machine learning models to use during the training and the testing of the data, so that they can have a futuristic insight on the sports analytics of that particular club or whatever or whichever that is the field. That can be athletics, it can be NBAs, that is basketball. It can be football.
Okay.
And for example, the coming up of the Euros.
Okay, maybe before you proceed to that, if I may just interrupt a bit, you have said that data science is wide.
It's wide.
And that I agree with you. Mm-hmm. It's a very wide and dynamic field. Mm-hmm. So we also have data analytics and we have sports analytics. So what you are saying is that sports analytics and data analytics are subsets of data science.
Yeah. Data analytics is a subset of data science.
Okay.
Because in order for you to become a data science, first you have to be having the skills of analyzing data.
Mm-hmm.
That is presentation of your data by using visuals and the different libraries in data science.
Yes.
Now, a data scientist is able to visualize data mm-hmm. and draw insight by making use of the programming language Python and also R. But a data analytics is equipped with the skills of visualizing data by making use of the tools like Power BI, Tableau.
Yeah, we have Excel. So basically, a data analyst focuses on exploration of that data.
Yes.
Okay. And now, will it be right if you now say that sports analytics is just data analytics that is applied in sports?
Yes. As we all know, data is the new oil.
Sure.
And in our day-to-day activities, it's data that is being collected. And in the field of sports, when these athletes will be doing their drills in the field, when these athletes will be performing in real matches at the end of the weekend, according to their league calendar, data is being able to be collected. That is the heat maps where the players were mostly concentrated at, more so for the defense part of it. When it comes to football, you're able to tell at this point maybe the center back or the right back was being overwhelmed by most of the opponent players being in that particular area. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So this can be a vital whereby now you are able to pick up your best players in according to the analytics and the data that will be collected. That of course will develop the analytics during the drill sessions and all.
So that means basically, regardless of the game, data analytics or other sports analytics can be applied to optimize the performance of the players.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes, of course.
Okay. Thank you, Tony. So now that we have seen sports analytics can be applied in any game, regardless of the nature, this sport analytics, What are some of the specific areas in specific games that can be applied maybe to improve and to optimize the performance?
Okay, thank you. But before I can get into the areas where they can be applied, as we all know, there is the market, there is the summer market whereby players are being transferred from one club to another.
Yeah, sure.
So with the analytics behind it and with the developing of the machine learning models from the data that will be trained for a particular player, sometimes it can be very vital during the pricing of that market player. Okay. Now, coming back to your question, whereby now we can apply all this. We all know there is the upcoming Euros, whereby the European countries will be, the countries from Europe will be participating in the Euros, whereby it happens in Europe.
Yeah.
Now, right now, all these clubs, or all these countries, they are preparing to start. Members of the European countries are now preparing so that they can participate in the competition and all.
Yeah.
And all of them want to win. And all of them are going to make use of historical data to know in the past Euros, how did they perform in the current one?
Yeah.
Will they be having the same team sheet as the one that was last time? And how did the players in different positions of the field perform? How did they perform?
Based on the traditional data.
And this will be now compared according to the other teams that will be coming in, that will be playing against, because they all know that they are fixtures currently.
Yeah.
And with the upcoming Euros, like I've said, more so with the use of the heat map during the analysis, they'll be able to know how to distribute their ball. The tactics will change. Now, this comes down, it narrows down to now the aspect of whereby the coaching doesn't have to be in the traditional one, whereby now coach has to pick the favorite ones and make them become the first 11 of the team sheet. And maybe the ones that he feels like they're not talented enough, they come later on as substitutes. Mm.
So this one will be solely based on the historical data, how they have been performing in the past.
How they have been performing in the past.
Yes.
And you see, for a player to be part of a country team, he also has to be participating actively in other countries, and it can be other leagues in other countries.
Yeah.
Now you see also that data they are able to pull up. Now, for example, if a player was a top-scoring player when they were participating in just the finished up league games
in different
countries,
yeah.
if it's a top-scoring player, then automatically that defines him to become the first 11 member of the first 11 squad.
Yeah.
Now, quote unquote, he will be on form.
Yeah.
Yeah. What we call on form, whereby now he's fit to participate very well.
Yeah.
And also, this doesn't guarantee him that being a top scorer, that he will be becoming the first 11 team sheet.
Yeah.
Also, right now, as they are in their training camps, there's also the measure of fitness.
The measure of fitness.
Because you can't be the other month, you can't be on form and on fit, but this month, you're not fit to participate.
So it could be these are now aspects that keep on changing.
These are aspects that keep on changing.
You could have been the top scorer, they just finished late, but now currently you're not physically fit.
You're not physically fit, yes.
But then this means there's a way in which these kinds of data are being collected.
Mm-hmm.
So these calls for, let me say, for instance, the use of some wearable gadgets to collect very vital data. Because when it comes to measuring whether somebody is fit physically, mentally, to participate in a game, it calls for the use of very high-tech gadgets to collect that data.
Yeah,
so is that not a challenge?
Okay, for them, it's not a challenge because the issue of innovation and the issue of funding is not a challenge for them.
It's not a challenge to them.
It's not a challenge for them because they've partnered up with Adidas, they've partnered up with Puma.
So they should they should incur the cost. They should not consider it as maybe a loss or what, because the cost incurred will boost or will help them boost their performance.
Yes.
In terms of the analysis that they'll be gathering from that.
Yes, of course.
Okay, I can see. So sports analytics seems to be a very interesting field.
It's very interesting. It's growing. There is a lot that is going on. Even some of the technology has been borrowed down. You can see nowadays we have the smartwatches whereby you can measure your heartbeat rate. It can be able to tell you how many steps you'll be able to walk and all. And now for the sports analytics, even during the game, as you've noticed, when they are done with their games, and some of them, when they pull out their shirts, they're able to see some sort of like special vests. This vest have some microchips that they're able to gather some of the data that and is being relay. Sent to their servers and in specific profiles for the players, for them to analyze the data during the game, after the game. Yeah. And also now there's the aspect of the cameras that are now collecting data that are pointed towards the field all over the stadium, and they are able to measure at this point what was supposed to be happening.
This means that a wide array of data is being collected and in very unstructured format. Because when you talk of videos, capturing data, those are very, such kind of data we know, it comes in a very unstructured format.
Yes.
And to analyze them needs some kind of algorithms and models.
Yes.
So that means sports analytics borrows much from data science and not data analytics.
So much.
It applies the use of algorithms and models in analyzing the structured data.
Yes.
So it's basically data science. So we would rather say data science in sports instead of sports analytics.
Yeah,
but it's okay. So, Tony, what drew your interest into sports analytics?
My interest into sports analytics is how they are able to determine when a player is fit. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's something very interesting.
Sure.
And this is depending on some of the drills that they carry out.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe the time it took to run 100 meters, maybe for a flanker, whereby now this is the number 7 and the number 11s who are on the wing side.
Yes.
And the reaction rate, the reaction rate, of course. Now, also this now comes into place in even video games.
Yeah.
When you play video games like the FIFA, right now we are at the FC 24.
Yeah.
When you play live, in the live format, you're able to tell whether this player is fit or not, by having a green lightning at the top of the profile of the player.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Sure. Yes. And that's very interesting because even when that is being borrowed to video, to video gaming, it shows that there is so much to explore in data. Yeah, and it proves that data is the new oil.
Sure.
Yeah.
You know, I can see that data has been applied in various fields, and now it's being applied in sports. So
yes.
Basically, no field is being left behind.
No field is being
left behind. We should embrace the use of data. What are you telling us? What can you tell our viewers in terms of data science and sports analytics? What are your last words to our viewers?
My last words to our viewers is data science, or rather any field of data, is a very, very growing field. And in whichever department you are at, you're handling data. And of course, for you to draw insight and to make meaningful decisions, you really need to know how to analyze this data in a very correct way. And we should all equip ourselves with that kind of skill.
Thank you, Tony. It's been a pleasure having you today.
Thank you.
To our viewers, you've heard from the experts, from the expert himself, that data is the new oil. So if you want to harvest from that oil well, you need to equip yourself with the skills that are necessary. And to do that, you can join us at African Center for Data Science. We have various trainings and certifications that equip you with the necessary skills in the field of data science. We have certification in data science. We have certification in data analytics. We have certification in artificial intelligence and several others. So if you're interested, you can visit our website. That is www.africdsa. revolutionized.com. Thank you. If you're not subscribed, kindly hit the subscribe button so that you don't miss such interesting episodes next time.